You're pretty.
What's biting, guys? Welcome to another episode of Fishing with Tiny Bassin. We're back over here at the Pier Park Pond, where it's kind of overcast. Only got about an hour or so to do some filming and fishing tonight. There's storms coming in. Hopefully we can get some fishing done before it starts raining. So y'all stay tight, but remember, don't matter if you're catching as long as you're fishing. So shut up and fish. So I'm going to get some baits in the water and see if I can catch some fish, guys. Hang tight, and again, welcome to Fishing with Tiny Bass. Yo. What's up going on, guys? I did some changing of my lures last night. I took off the little white spinnerbait, and I went with a red and black spinnerbait. And I put a watermelon red swim fluke on there as my trailer. I'm going to give this a few casts and see what bites, guys. Here's first cast. Again, like I say, I don't usually like catching them on the first cast. Usually means bad luck. So maybe we won't catch one on the first cast, but hopefully maybe second cast we'll get one for you. Here we go. Alright, first cast out of the way. Now let's see if we can catch one. Sun's starting to peak up. The clouds went away a little bit. Sun's starting to peak up. Maybe one of these fish will see the sunlight come out and decide they want to do a little biting. I went over to the marina and did some saltwater fishing yesterday, guys. The video should be up by the time this one gets put up. So it was very, very windy over there. So I'm sorry about the wind in that video, guys, but this one should be a little bit better. It's not as windy here at the pond. It is out there at the ocean, though. I can hear it whooping. So y'all hang tight, and we're going to see what bites. I'm fixing to throw on that little crick copper and see if I can get something on it. I remember I caught two with a crick copper last time I was out here, guys. Of course, I still ain't posted that video yet. Sorry about that, but I will get it up. It'll be up before this one will, so I hope you enjoy that video. Take a chance. We got some ducks out here again with us today. I actually ran them off their little spot. They was right here in front of me when I come down here. So they're probably not too happy with me because I ran them off their spot. But y'all hang tight, guys. We're going to see if we can get something for you. And we'll be right back. Alright guys, going back to the little trusty, Crick Hopper. Cast it a few times, see if we can get maybe even a tiny bassin. Here we go guys. You said on this, I can normally catch something on it when I can't catch on anything else. So if there's even a little tiny bassin, guys, hopefully we'll get him for you. With them ducks being here, I hope it didn't scare all the bass or any of the fish off. I might have to move on down a little bit. Them ducks might have done had all the fish off of this area. They were all piled up right here where I was until I walked down here. Alright guys, we on. I got one on the Crick Hopper. There we go.
Pretty big one.
Got a good one. Get him on the Crick Hopper, guys. There we go. And get these little trebles out. Got him good in that treble right there. Had to get the pliers on him, guys. Hold on one moment. There we go. It hooks out. Caught him on the little Fire Tiger Crick Hopper. And there he is. So, I don't know, maybe about half a pound, three quarters of a pound. Put up a pretty good fight. Sorry we didn't get the whole fight on there on it, guys. Didn't have the camera on, but he did a pretty good jump. Hang tight, guys. We're going to get a few pictures. We'll be right back with the release. Alright guys, well, got some pictures of the little guy. Time for the release, guys. Here we go. You ready? Here he goes. There he went. Well guys, told you, the old trusty Crick Hopper does the job. Hang tight, I'm gonna throw it a few more times while you're on film here. Maybe we can get the whole catch. Again, apologize for that, guys. Took a little bit of time for the camera to turn on. Like I said, he missed a jump, but it was a good little fight. Here we go. Yeah, a couple bass. All right, guys, keep throwing this a few more times and then hopefully we can get something on there for you. They hit it pretty good. All right, guys, I'm gonna keep throwing this a few more times. Hang tight. Hopefully, if we get another one on, we can get the camera to wake up a little quicker, and you can see more of the fight. But at least we got the catch in. You got to see the fish. So hang tight, guys. Let's see what bites. All right, guys, got another one. This is a pretty good one on the creek copper. Hopefully, it don't come off. Another pretty good one on the creek copper. All right, we're gonna flip him up. Here we go, number two on the creek copper. Got a little more of the fight though, guys. Yeah, some lettuce with him. Here we go. Go ahead and get out the pliers here. Right there. So you got that creek copper. Here we go. Hook's out. Number two on the creek copper. Another one about the same size as that last one. About a half a pound, three quarters of a pound. Hang tight, guys. We're gonna get a few pictures of this guy. We'll be right back with the release. All right, guys, number two on the creek copper. Let's get ready for the release. Here we go, guys. There he goes. Number two, fishing with Tiny Bassin'. Trusty Creek Copper, Fire Tiger color. Well, let's see if we can get another one, guys. I was just about ready to put on some live bait for my wife, and decided to throw the Creek Copper one more time, and he got it. Let's throw a few more times, guys. Don't forget, don't matter if you're catching, as long as you're fishing. So shut up and fish, guys. But I'm doing both. I'm catching, I'm fishing, but I'm shutting up and I'm getting back to it. Guys, got another little tiny bass and kind of snagged him. That's what you call a tiny bass. I don't know what you thought. He was about the size of the dang Creek Copper. All right, little feller. There we go. I don't even know if I can lip him, guys. That's the littlest one yet. That tiny bassin right there. That's what you call tiny bassin. Check it out. Here's what he... Look at the size difference, guys. He actually jumped a bunch. I guess because I had him hooked by hook, but... Hang tight, guys. I actually got a picture of this thing, and then I'll be right back with a release. All right, guys, we're back. I got a couple little photos of the tiny bass. Let's get ready for the release. Here we go. That little fella's gone. All right, guys, I'm gonna shut up and throw the Creek Copper some more. That was a funny little tiny bassin right there. That's what you call fishing with tiny bassin. All right, guys, hang tight. Let's see if we can get something else to bite. Again, the scammer's acting up. Took me a while forever to get it to turn on. Otherwise, you could see the fault because he bit way out there and it wasn't, he jumped, I don't know how many times to be so small. Luckily, we got it turned on right at the end though. Hopefully we'll, just hang tight and we'll let you stay here and let me throw a few times, and heck, I can always cut some video out if I don't need it. Maybe we can get one on while we're filming. I hadn't even had a chance to throw anything else. I keep catching with the Creek Copper. It's old trusty. I was gonna put on some live bait for the wife. This has turned out to be the best day so far. I hadn't even moved to the other spot. I was going to walk up and fish that other spot where that one bass was bedding. That I had in the Persistence Pays Off video. But I hadn't even had a chance to do that. As long as they bite in here, I'm going to hang tight and try to keep catching them. Sun's about to go down, so... I don't know how much filming light we're going to have, but maybe we'll at least get a couple more on for you. They've all been coming fairly deep right. I'm gonna stand up here and see if I can get a little better cast in for you. right, guys, hang tight. We'll be right back if we get another one on. I think I'm gonna actually try throwing that little frog with the jig head with an underspin. Change it up to a little bit of lighter color frog. See how it works. Maybe I can get a little further out with it. Hang tight and we'll see what bites. All right, guys. Got a little frog here with a little chartreuse jig head with a little underspin. Went with a little lighter color frog than I had on last time. Got the red hook. Let's give it a few casts. Got it on my wife's little pink pole here. It's got 25 pound braid on it, so we got a bigger one. Let's see if we can get something on it. At least give them a little something different to look at. I got a few more things I want to throw too before it gets too late. I got a drop shot rig with a little crawl on it I want to give a try. And also, I'd like to try some live bait. I have yet to catch a fish in live bait on a worm or something in Florida since I've been here, and I don't understand how that's possible. So maybe we can tonight. Hang tight, guys, we'll be right back. All right, guys, got another little tiny bassin. You ain't gonna believe this. I was throwing a little drop shot rig, and I was reeling it in, and right when I was getting close to the bank, something tried to eat my drop shot sinker. So I told my wife to hand me my crick copper rod real quick. I threw out there and I caught another little tiny bassin. Another little guy like the one before. Hang tight, we're going to get a picture of him, and we're going to release him, guys. We'll be right back. Alright, guys, ready for the release of the little tiny bassin. It makes four. Two tiny bassin, two pretty good sizes. Here we go. There goes the little tiny bassin. Let me throw a couple more times with the crick copper here and see if there's another little tiny bassin right here. If not, I'm gonna go back with that drop shot rig. I've missed a couple on the drop shot. Throw this a few more times because they're really liking the crick copper tonight or this evening. I'd like to get another pretty nice one for you. But it's fun even catching the tiny bassin, because remember, it don't matter if you're catching as long as you're fishing. So shut up and fish, guys. That's what my hat says. That's what my motto is. So let's see if I can get a couple more for you. Got a little hit right there, didn't take it. I don't know how the recording light's getting, guys. The sun's getting down pretty well. Maybe we got a little bit more recording light for y'all. took a minute for the camera again. I don't know what's taking so long. It's taking its time trying to turn on. So we're missing a lot. So that's why my wife, she's just trying to do some filming right now. And what I don't need, I can cut out. We'd like to get one full catch on there for you guys. We've missed a couple nice fights with a couple nice jumps because camera wasn't turned on quick enough. Seaweed or pond weed, shall I say? We ain't in the sea. Alright, a couple more casts, guys, and I'm gonna go back with that drop shot rig because I can get a little further out there. Fish it a little slower. I just so happened, like I said, that one little tiny bass in there, I'd had a bite and I was reeling in real quick to so I could get back out there, and so happened he ate my little drop shot sinker, which I'll show you here in a minute when I get the drop shot back on, if you can see me, because it's getting a little dark filming. Sun's already went down, but maybe we can get a little bit more filming light. There we go. This is a good one, guys. Got another nice one. Another nice one. Oh, he's pulling drag, guys. There we go. The old crick hopper doing his job. Ah. Here we go, stay on. Get out of that. Come on, get out of that. Here we go. Here we go. There we go. It's a little bit bigger than the other. Ooh, I barely had him hooked, guys. Look at that. If you can see, watch this. That was all I had him by, guys. Just barely had that one hooked. Luckily, I got him in, though. Another one on the crick hopper. He's a little bit bigger than the other ones. Still about the same. This one might be about a pound. There we go, guys. We're going to get a couple of photos of this guy. And we'll be right back with the release, guys. Hang tight. Fishing with Tiny Bassin. Alright, guys, we got a couple shots of him. Hopefully they turned out. Get ready for the release, guys. Here we go. Fishing with Tiny Bassin. Here we go. There he goes. All right, guys. This film, I don't know how it's turning up because it's getting awful late. Getting kind of dark. So I'm going to go ahead and do this little outro now. But I'm still going to fish. Maybe get a little bit more footage for you. But guys, we had an awesome trip here at the pond this evening. Only was out here about an hour. Caught, I think, two or three tiny bass. I think three tiny bass or so. And three pretty good sized bass. But remember, guys, it doesn't matter if you're catching, as long as you're fishing. So shut up and fish, guys. This is Tiny Bass, and I hope you enjoyed this episode. If you did, remember to like this video, share this video, but more importantly, subscribe to my channel, Fishing with Tiny Bassin, guys. And you can also follow me on Facebook. I'll have the links in the description below. Guys, remember, shut up and fish, guys. We love y'all, and we'll catch y'all on the flip side.